entertainment-saturated Southern California, it takes a lot to get 10,000 people to Irwindale Speedway on a Thursday night. Spectacular drifting by D1 Series stars like Reese Millen and Samuel Hubinette wasn't enough. So there was plenty to see and drink off the track as well. Still not enough? Then how about NASCAR Nextel Cup drivers like Casey Kane, Bill Elliott, Matt Kenseth, Robbie Gordon, Greg Biffle, Scott Wimmer, and Casey Mears trying their hands at drifting? That was clearly enough, as fans were lined up 2 hours before the gates opened in anticipation of seeing their D1 and NASCAR heroes up close. The drivers would be risking their reputations in what was billed as the Mopar D1 All-Star Duel presented by Shift Into Gear. The fans all had opinions up front.
Really? You okay about the NASCAR guys?
Nah. Not really.
They can't do what a drifter can do anyway.
We just want to see how many of the NASCAR guys hit the wall.
Yeah!
Who's going to be the better drifter from the NASCAR guys?
From the NASCAR guys? Well, let's see, who spins best? Robbie Gordon. I would think just because he's used to spinning and spinning other people, he'd probably be good at it.
Going in, Gordon looked like a good bet to drifter Reese Millen.
How was he out there, Reese?
Fantastic. You know, the car is set up similar to a rally car, stadium car, or his trophy truck, so I knew that he was going to adapt to it straight away. Two laps and he was on top of it. He'd probably be ready to run the big oval.
Have you ever seen drifting before?
I have seen drifting before. Paid a bit of attention to it through the magazine and stuff, and then obviously Speed Channel does some stuff with it as well, so it's always looked like a lot of fun.
Then, well, things didn't quite work out. However, Gordon's wall slam was the only one all night. The NASCAR guys ran Irwindale's small inner course while the D1 pros took off around the higher speed course that incorporated more of the track's oval. As a shootout, this event wasn't much. But as entertainment, it was big, stupid fun. Bill Elliott seemed a natural drifting out there, but his borrowed Infinity only lasted one lap. Casey Kane, however, was constantly getting better in Samuel Hubinette's Viper. By the end of the night, he seemed like he was ready to dump NASCAR and take up drifting full time. In fact, the D1 duel raised $30,000 for the Casey Kane Foundation, which must have put Kane in a good mood, because that weekend at nearby California Speedway, he went on to win both Saturday's Busch race and Sunday's Nextel Cup event.